conference. Today's topic of discussion is World Trade Organization's Agreement on Agriculture. Relevance of this topic with respect to RBI Grade B will be in Phase 2, Paper 2, Economic and Social Issues under WTO. With respect to NABARD Grade A will be in Phase 1, Economic and Social Issues. Phase 2, Paper 2, Economic and Social Issues under WTO. WTO is the successor to GATT, which was the first worldwide multilateral free trade agreement and was in effect from June 30, 1948 until January 1, 1995. WTO was developed through 8 rounds of multilateral trade negotiations held under GATT. 8th round, that is the last round, is popularly known as Uruguay round. Main objectives of WTO is to improve the standard of living of people in the member countries, ensure full employment, enlarge production of goods, increase in trade of goods and services, protect the environment, etc. Very, very important slide from exam point of view. Presently, WTO has 164 members, with Afghanistan became its latest member in 2016. Remember the names of all four recent member countries and their respective year of joining. All the decisions are made by consensus among the member countries. Talking about the structure of WTO, Ministerial Conference is the top level decision making body, followed by General Council. Another thing to remember that Ministerial Conference meets at least once every 2 years, while General Council meets several times a year. Below General Council, there are Good Council, Services Council and Intellectual Property Council. The Director General of WTO has 4-year term and Roberto Azevedo is its current Director General, who was reappointed on 1st September 2017 by WTO members. Another thing to remember that the Secretariat of WTO is located in Geneva, Switzerland. Given picture shows all the 11 ministerial conferences of WTO starting from 1996 to 2017. Remember the year and host city of first conferences, fourth conference and ninth conference, tenth conference and latest being the 11th conference. WTO is often described as rules-based, that is, a system based on rules. Remember the names of some of the important WTO agreements and their purpose, like Agreement on Agriculture, GATS for Service Sector, TRIPS for Intellectual Property Regulation, SPS for Food Safety, as well as Plant and Animal Health, etc. In this presentation, WTO's Agreement on Agriculture will be discussed in detail. WTO's Agreement on Agriculture was negotiated during the last round of multilateral trade negotiations held under GATT and came into force on 1st January 1995. The agreement is based on three pillars, that is, domestic support, market access and export subsidies, with the aim of removing trade barriers and promoting transparent market access. First pillar of WTO's Agreement on Agriculture is the domestic support, which refers to direct and product specific subsidies like guaranteed minimum price or input subsidies. Important to remember that under this, subsidies are categorized into three boxes, that is green, blue and amber box. Green box subsidies are not targeted at particular product and don't include any direct income support for farmers like environment protect, R&D, farmer training program, etc. Important to remember that they are allowed without any limit because they cause no or little trade distortion in agriculture sector. Like green box, blue box subsidies are also allowed without any limit because only production limiting subsidies are allowed under it. Direct payments will be made to farmer on fixed areas, yields, number of livestock in base year. On the other hand, amber box include input subsidies on electricity, seed, fertilizers, irrigation, etc., which will cause trade distortion in agriculture sector. Due to this, it is subjected to limits known de minimis levels. Very important to remember the de minimis provisions. Under this, developed countries and developing countries are allowed to maintain amber box subsidies to the level of 5% and 10% of total value of agricultural production respectively, which is to be calculated from the base year 1986 to 1988. Second pillar of WTO's agreement on agriculture is market access. Its aim to cut tariffs, that is, a tax or duty which is to be paid on particular class of imports and exports by the countries in order to allow free trade. Further, it also aims to remove those trade barriers that restrict imports, exports of goods or services. Given two pictures shows summary of all the three subsidy boxes. Most important thing to remember that WTO fixed no limit for green and blue box subsidies, while limit is fixed for the amber box subsidies, which is 5% and 10% of the total value of agricultural production for developing and developed countries respectively. Third pillar of WTO's agreement on agriculture is export subsidy. It aims to encourage export of goods and discourage sale of goods on the domestic market through direct payments, low-cost loans, tax relief for exporters, etc., which can damage domestic agriculture sector of other countries as highly cheaper products will be available in that country. Special safeguard mechanism would allow developing countries to impose additional duties in case of abnormal surge in imports or entry of unusual cheap imports. Given picture shows all the three pillars of WTO's agreement on agriculture. I again repeat to remember their names. As explained in the earlier section, that under the de minimis provision, developed and developing countries are allowed to maintain amber box subsidies to the level of 5% and 10% of the total value of agricultural production respectively, which is calculated from the base year 1986 to 1988. Peace clause was proposed in the 9th Ministerial Conference of WTO held at Bali in 2013. It provided 4-year reprieve during which no country would be penalized if subsidies breach the limit set by WTO. After the expiry of reprieve period, India wants permanent solution to issue of farm subsidies linked to national food security. India wants permanent solution to the issue of limit set by WTO on amber box subsidies because it is impacting India's social welfare schemes. India wants that the method of calculating subsidies under agreement on agriculture should be changed as under the de minimis provision, base year for calculation of total value of agricultural production is taken as 1986 to 1988, which extrapolates the extent of any subsidy. Further, India wants that the subsidy computation methodology should be designed in such a way that it reflects current international prices. Time for a quick revision. First, WTO is a successor to GATT and came into being in 1995. Second, WTO has developed through 8 rounds of multilateral trade negotiations under GATT, and last round is popularly known as Uruguay round. Third, WTO has 164 members, and remember the latest countries which became its member. Fourth, WTO secretariat is based in Geneva and Robert Esvedo is its current director general. Fifth, remember the 1st, 4th, 9th, 10th, 11th ministerial conferences of WTO. Remember all the three pillars of WTO agreement on agriculture. 7th, remember green, blue and amber box subsidies. 8th, remember de minimis provision.
MCQs are for practice.
and are based on the content discussed so far. Kindly solve them for better understanding. Thank you and happy learning.